Dear friends, today I am going to talk on probability. Let us see the introduction. In daily life, we face many situations where the results are not certain. With the help of probability theory, one can make an attempt to measure the degree of uncertainty in the results of such situations. The theory of probability was originated from the gambling, but in current scenario, it is useful in all the fields of decision making. Mathematicians Galileo, Pascal, Fermat, Bernoulli, De Moivre, Bayes, Laplace, etc. have given important contribution in developing the theory of probability. Whereas Chebyshev, Markov, Lyapunov, Kinchin and Kolmogorov have made very valuable contributions to the modern theory of probability. The probability theory is the mixture of set theory and counting. In counting, mainly two things called permutations and combination play vital role. Among these items, permutations and combination can be explained as. Let us see permutation. If one thing can be done in m different ways, and if with each way of doing it, there are n ways of doing another thing, the two things together can be done in m cross n ways is called permutation. Let us see combination. The number of ways of selecting r things out of n different things is called combination. Let us see the terms used in probability theory. Number 1. Random experiment. An experiment which can result in any one of the several outcomes is called a random experiment. As for example, tossing of a coin. Second, sample space. A set of representing all possible outcomes of a random experiment is called a sample space. As for example, if coin is tossed, then its sample space is U equal to head and tail. We denote here head by H, tail by T. Third, events. The outcomes of an experiment are known as the events. As for example, if a coin is tossed, then two different events are head and tail. Fourth, complementary events. The complement of a particular event is the aggregate of all the sample points of a sample space which do not belong to the particular event. As for example, if a coin is tossed, then head is the complementary event of a tail. Fifth, exhaustive events. If all possible outcomes of an experiment are considered, the outcomes are said to be exhaustive. As for example, if a coin is tossed, then exhaustive events are head and tail. Sixth, mutually exclusive events. Any events are said to be mutually exclusive if they cannot occur together. As for example, if a coin is tossed, then head and tail are called mutually exclusive events. Seventh, equally likely events. Events are said to be equally likely if chance of getting an outcomes are same. As for example, if a coin is tossed, then head and tail are equally likely events. Eighth, favorable events. The members of a sample space which are favorable for an event are called favorable events. As for example, if a die is tossed and a person is interested to get even number, then the favorable events are 2, 4, 6. Ninth, independent events. Events are said to be independent if the happening of an event does not depend upon the happening or non-happening of the other events of the experiment. As for example, if a coin is tossed, then the outcomes of head or tail does not depend on the outcome tail or head. Thus, head and tail are independent events. Conditional events. The event is called a conditional event if happening of the event is depending upon the happening of the other event or events. As for example, if one card is selected and it is found of red, then there is chance that it is a king of red. Thus, getting a king, given that the selected card is red, then the conditional event is denoted as a king given red. Conditional event is denoted by A given B. Let us move to now definition of probability. Classical or mathematical definition. If an experiment can result in n exhaustive, mutually exclusive and equally likely ways, and if m of them are favorable to the happening of an event A, then the probability of happening of an event A is defined as the ratio of m to n. Probability A is given by m upon n. Let us see axiomatic or modern definition. The modern concept of probability was introduced by Russian mathematician Kolmogorov with the help of set theory. If probability of event A is real number assigned to a subset A of a random space S, then it is called the probability of an event A, provided PA satisfy the axioms, which are, first, 0 less than equal to probability A less than equal to 1. Second, probability of sample space S equal to 1. And third, if A1, A2, A3 and so on is infinite sequence of disjoint events, then probability of event A is called probability of an event A. In probability theory, some theorems are used. Their statements can be considered as follow. First, probability of A dash equal to 1 minus probability of A. Second, if A and B are any two events, then probability of A union B equal to probability A plus probability B minus probability A intersection B. For two events A and B, probability of B given A equal to probability of B intersection A divided by probability A. But here probability A should not be 0. That is, probability B intersection A equal to probability B given A into probability A. Now let us see the Bayes theorem. If event B can happen with mutually exclusive and exhaustive events A1, A2, A3 and so on AN, and if the probabilities PA1, PA2, PA3 up to PAN, and also the conditional probabilities probability B given A1, probability of B given A2 and so on probability of B given AN are known, then the inverse probability of happening of an event AI under the condition that the event B has happened is given by formula probability AI given B equal to probability AI intersection B divided by probability B, which we can simplify as probability AI given B divided by probability A1 intersection B plus probability A2 intersection B and so on up to plus probability AN intersection B. Or we can again write the probability AI given B as equal to probability AI into probability B given AI divided by probability A1 into probability B given A1 plus probability A2 into probability B given A2 plus so on up to probability AN into probability B given AN. Let us now see some examples based on probability. First example, it is an example of classical probability. Determine the probabilities of the following events in drawing card from a standard deck of 52 cards. First event, A7, B, a black card, C, an ace or a king, D, a black 2 or a black 3, E, a red face card. Solution: A. There are 4 cards of 7 and therefore the probability of 7 equal to 4 by 52, which becomes equal to 1 upon 13. B. There are 26 black cards. Therefore, the probability of black card becomes 26 upon 52 equal to 1 by 2. C. There are 4 ace and 4 king in a deck of 52 cards. Therefore, the probability of ace or king becomes 8 by 52, which equal to 2 upon 13. D. There are 2 black color cards of 2 and two black color cards of 3. Therefore, probability of black 2 or 3 equal to 4 by 52 equal to 1 upon 13. E. There are 6 face cards of red color. Therefore, probability of red face card equal to 6 by 52 equal to 3 by 26. Let us see example number 2. Example based on counting. An urn contains 75 marbles, 35 are blue, and 25 of these blue marbles are swirled. The rest of them are red, and 30 of the red ones are swirled. The marbles that are not swirled are clear. What is the probability of drawing A. blue marble from the urn, B. a clear marble from the urn, C. a blue swirled marble, D. a red clear marble, and E. a swirled marble. Solution. Here we find from the given information that total number of marbles we denote by capital N equal to 75, blue 35, 25 blue swirled, 10 blue clear, red 40, 30 red swirled, 10 red clear. And hence, the probability of blue marble becomes 35 upon 75, which comes out 7 by 15. B. Probability of clear marble equal to 10 plus 10 upon 75, which comes out 4 by 15. C. Probability of blue and swirled marble equal to 25 upon 75, which becomes 1 upon 3. D. Probability of red and clear marble equal to 10 by 75 equal to 2 by 15. E. Probability of swirled marble equal to 25 plus 30 divided by 75 comes out 11 upon 15. Or we can find the same solution by considering 1 minus probability of clear marble equal to 1 minus 4 by 15 equal to 11 by 15. Let us see example number 3, which is example of joint probability. A bag contains 32 marbles, 4 are red, 9 are black, 12 are blue, 6 are yellow, and 1 is purple. Marbles are drawn one at a time with replacement. What is the probability that A, second marble is yellow, given that the first one was yellow? B, the second marble is yellow, given that the first one was black. C. Third marble is purple, given both the first and second were purple. Let us see the solution of the problem. A. Here, the first marble drawn was yellow. Now, this marble is replaced in the same box, then the second marble is drawn from the box. Here, the result of the second draw does not depend on the outcome of the first draw. So, probability of getting yellow marble at the second draw is same as the probability of drawing yellow marble from the box. Here we denote yellow marble by notation capital Y. So, hence probability Y equal to 6 by 32. B. As discussed in the case A, as an experiment is done by with replacement, there is no effect of the first draw on the outcome of the second draw. The probability of getting yellow marble at the second draw, whatever be the outcome at the first draw, is same as the probability of getting yellow marble at the first draw. Hence, required probability of yellow marble becomes 6 by 32. C. Here also, probability of getting purple marble at the third draw is same as the probability of getting purple marble at the first draw. Probability of purple marble at the third draw equal to 1 by 32. Let us move our fourth example on probability, which is example of conditional probability. At a soup kitchen, a social worker gathers the following data. Of this visiting the kitchen, 59% are men, 32% are alcoholics, and 21% are male alcoholics. What is the probability that a random male visitor to the kitchen is an alcoholic? Let us see the solution. The probability of alcoholic given male equal to probability of male and alcoholic divided by probability of male equal to 0.21 divided by 0.59, which comes out equal to 0.356. Let us see example number 5th. It is based on conditional probability. During a study of auto accidents, the Highway Safety Council found that 60% of all accidents occur at night, 52% are alcohol related, and 37% occur at night and alcohol related. A. What is the probability that an accident was alcohol related given that it occurred at night? B. What is the probability that an accident occurred at night given that it was alcohol related? Let us see the solution for part A. Probability A given N equal to probability A and N divided by probability N, which is equal to 0.37 divided by 0.60, which is equal to 0.617. Let us move B part. Probability N given A equal to probability A and N divided by probability A equal to 0.37 divided by 0.52, which comes out 0.712. Let us see the example number 6. Based on Bayes' theorem, a company is planning its company picnic. The only thing that will cancel the picnic is a thunderstorm. The weather service has predicted dry conditions with probability 0.2, moist condition with probability 0.45, and wet condition with probability 0.35. If the probability of thunderstorm given dry condition is 0.3, given moist condition is 0.6, and given wet condition is 0.8, what is the probability of thunderstorm? If we know the picnic was indeed cancelled, what is the probability moist condition were in effect? Let us summarize the given data in the following table. This table we have prepared 5 columns. First column indicate event, second column indicate its probability, third indicate the probability of storm given event, fourth column indicate probability of storm and event, and last column indicate probability of event given storm. In the second row, the events are defined as a dry, corresponding probability is 0.20, probability of storm given event is 0.30, and probability of storm and event becomes the product of these two probability of column number 2nd and 3 becomes 0.06, and hence probability of event given storm becomes 0.06 divided by the total of the column number 4 probability storm equal to 0.61, which comes out 0.0984. For event moist, the probability is 0.45. Probability of storm given event is 0.60, and probability storm and event is 0.27. Therefore, the probability of event moist given storm becomes 0.27 divided by 0.61, which comes out 0.4426. And now for wet event, the probability is 0.35. The probability of storm given event is 0.80. And probability of storm and event becomes 0.28, and hence the probability of event given storm becomes 0.28 divided by 0.61 becomes 0.4590. The probability of a thunderstorm is 0.61. The probability of moist condition given that the picnic was cancelled, that is, given that there was a thunderstorm, is 0.4426. Summary. We have discussed probability as one of the important tools to get solution of daily life where we face many situations and where the results are not certain. With the help of probability theory, one can make an attempt to measure the degree of uncertainty in the results of such situations. All distributions are based on probability theory. It is also heavily used for getting decision in business and economics.